God's amazing grace was evident to our family at the very beginning of our first term in Cambodia. We can truthfully say that our first term started with a bang. 2 weeks after we arrived, on June 16, 1997, the second prime minister staged a military coup against the first prime minister and his leaders. Many politicians were murdered during the coup and in the months following, and hundreds of innocent civilians were wounded or killed. We are thankful for God's protection of our family during that time. Because of the political unrest, we left Cambodia and spent 1 month in nearby Singapore. Fellow Baptist World Missionaries Pat and Mary Delaney and a supporting church, Baptist Fellowship Church, took good care of us there. Our children were glad to make some new friends. We were very happy to return to our home in Phnom Penh in August. God had led us to a home with a ready-made meeting room on the rooftop. We began holding Bible studies in English that same month. By the end of 1997, several young men had been saved and baptized. The unrest in the government remained throughout 1998, as national elections were held only 1 year after the coup. Cambodians desperately want peace and have never found it through their political leaders. We have observed that this lack of peace in their country has driven the people to live in constant fear. What a joy it is to share with them the truth of the gospel and how God's grace alone can bring peace to their hearts. Language study was one important area where we needed God's grace. Deborah and I began studying the language in September of 1997. Learning to speak was a huge challenge in itself, but learning to read and write was even more difficult, especially since the Cambodian language has more letters in its alphabet than any other language in the world. Hey, let's forget language study for a minute and take a boat ride up the Tonle Sap River. God's grace has been so evident in our family. We have grown in number by two since we began our first term. Our two youngest children were born in Bangkok, Thailand. We are thankful for the opportunities our children have had over the past 4 years. They often provided special music for our church services at the beginning of our term. With the help of the Johnsons, our five oldest children have been able to start playing instruments and again provide some special music for the church. From the time that I knew God was calling me to the mission field, I felt that God would have us work as part of a missionary team. We came to Cambodia through the influence of Jim and Kathy Hayes, veteran missionaries in Thailand. The Hayes returned to Phnom Penh in early 1998, and within a few months helped us make the transition from English to Khmer church services. Shortly before the Hayes moved back to their former ministry in Thailand, Vince and Renee Bowles arrived in May of 1998. For 2 years, the Bowles played a vital role in the work in Phnom Penh, and then felt the Lord leading them to minister in a southeastern province of Cambodia near Vietnam. We thank the Lord that because of Vince's computer expertise, our team has been able to produce two gospel tracks and a video presentation of the gospel. Here is a brief excerpt of the True God video.
Nekan Sasana Tiang No ban thưa cột trung nơi lơ chưa chàng pon tai ca ní cứ chia pan ca rọ bò prete nơi pe đài pre Giêsu ban so cột nơi lơ chưa chàng trung ban tổ tua vô.
We have also written discipleship lessons to help new believers grow. Tom and Anna Johnson joined us in May of 2000. Their soul-winning zeal and talent in the field of music have been a great encouragement to all of us. God has also led Forrest and Jennifer McPhail to work with us during their first term in Cambodia. Like our other teammates, they are also willing servants of the Lord and have already been used to touch the lives of many Cambodians. From the beginning, we were thankful for our house with its rooftop church. When the time came for the annual water festival, we discovered that this popular Cambodian holiday brought thousands of Cambodians to our street right in front of our church. We were able to put together a gospel puppet show and present it in our own front yard. In 3 years, thousands have heard the gospel. In the year 2000, many were saved through this special evangelistic outreach. Another special activity for the Independence Baptist Church in Phnom Penh is our annual Christmas program. Because Cambodia is a Buddhist country, Christmas is not even considered a holiday. Few Cambodians understand the meaning of Christmas. However, they are very curious about it, and this makes Christmas a wonderful opportunity to give the gospel. This past year, around 600 people attended the Christmas play, which was presented on three different nights. Others have heard of God's amazing grace through special evangelistic activities, like Cambodia's first teen Cola Clash, led by summer missionary intern Greg Hoffman. Let me take you through an average Sunday in our ministry. We begin in Phnom Penh at IBC, Independence Baptist Church, with Sunday school classes at 8:30 in the morning. We have three classes for men, women, and children, and also an evangelistic Sunday school class for any first-time visitors so that they can hear a clear presentation of the gospel. At 10 o'clock, we have our morning worship service. It has been thrilling to see new Christians study the Bible and learn to sing songs of praises to the Lord. We then go to the Sphairalung villages for their afternoon service at 2:30. Many people from this area have been saved and baptized. We are thankful that on January 28, 2001, we started having services for this group of Christians right in their own area. Satan has aggressively opposed this work, but God's grace has triumphed.
Our ministry here in Sphairalung in June of last year.
For friends. And King Nebuchadnezzar had chosen these four boys. Okay, and I'm going to tell you their names.
A baptism there means taking a short walk to the river. Then we quickly head back to Phnom Penh for our evening service in English at 5 o'clock. The Lord has given us opportunities to minister to people of many different nationalities through this service.
In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. God's people said,
Amen.
Yes, my name is George Pereira. I'm from Sri Lanka. Through the discipleship or through God's grace, I have trusted Him on the 24th of June. And now I have believed in Him. And it's a great joy to know that Christ lives in me and I am His disciple.
We want to thank you for your part through financial support and prayer in giving these dear people the opportunity to hear of God's amazing grace. These are the faces of some who have experienced that amazing grace. Those you will meet in heaven someday because you were willing to give and to pray. What a joy it is to hear some of them sing, I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. Are you also willing to go? Millions of Cambodians still blindly follow the false religion of Buddhism because they know of nothing else. But many will not see without someone to tell them of the amazing grace of our Savior. There is much work yet to do.